Moana is the newest film from the Disney Animation Studios, and it's by the same creative team that gave us such classics as Aladdin, The Great Mouse Detective, The Princess and the Frog, Treasure Planet, and The Little Mermaid. And it is about the title character of the film, Moana. She is a princess, and she is a chief of these island folks. And these island folks, they don't like to explore. They like to stay where they are. It's pretty safe for them. They don't like to explore beyond the horizon. But then she embarks on this journey where she has to find this demigod named Maui. He stole something and now he has to return it. And in return, he'll help her save her island. And now we have this movie. Now, just like movies like Sausage Party, Finding Dory, Zootopia, Kung Fu Panda 3, and much other animated films that came out this year, this movie was very high on my anticipation list. Mainly because this is like the first Hawaiian princess. And I like seeing when Disney, they bring more diversity to their Disney princess lineup. And it definitely shows in this movie. They definitely represent the culture in this film and how it plays a part in the film. And it definitely shows, not just off of the creative team, because I knew that this would be a competent team that would give us a great animated film, but it also goes to the voice cast. Like Dwayne The Rock Johnson, who plays the voice of Maui. He plays a demigod, and he lost something, and he needs that to bring back his demigodness. And at his core, like, he's a bit of a dick, but at his core, he is... You can see that he is kind of a damaged guy and that he just wants to feel needed and wanted again. That he just wants nothing best but for the people that he protects. And The Rock definitely brings that to this character. Like, The Rock, he continues to show us why he's one of the most charismatic wrestlers turned actors in the business right now. He's just so likable and he definitely brings that to this character. And for the young actress that plays the voice of Moana, I'm not even going to try to pronounce her name, but I'm going to just say that If her next film is anything that she brings to this film, she definitely has a bright future ahead of her. Because she has a beautiful voice, her voice acting is great, and she definitely did a good job of bringing Moana to life. Because Moana, she was bred to be like this leader in chief, but then she wants to know, she thinks that there's life outside of what she's used to, and she just wants to explore that. And Maui, he helps her with that. Like, she brings a sense of curiousness to her character. And the songs in this movie is fantastic. Like, all the songs were mostly written by Lin-Manuel Miranda, who you may know as the guy behind the Hamilton play. The music he writes for this movie is meaningful, and it adds to the story. Like, there's two songs in this movie that could possibly be the next Let It Go. Now, I don't know if it'll reach the heights of Let It Go, but until it reaches the heights of Let It Go and we all get sick of it, I'ma enjoy them, and I think you all will enjoy it too. Like, there's just two songs in particular. Like, one is sung by The Rock, it's called You're Welcome, and by the end of the movie, I was just tapping my feet and tuning to it. And Moana, the character, she has a couple of songs in this movie that's definitely in the narrative of the story, and I think definitely probably get an Oscar nomination for Best Original Song for a Movie. The journey in this movie is also fascinating, but it also might be a slight negative because the journey with them in the ocean trying to get to their next destination to the next, it kind of slows the movie down, but it doesn't slow it down too much because I think that this whole movie rests on the shoulder of the two characters, Moana and Maui. And because the two characters are so charismatic and charming, you're instantly just want to be with them and having fun with them. And the animation in this movie is beautiful. Like, this is the best animation that Disney Animation has brought out. And everything just looks so photorealistic. And while this movie definitely does have heart and a good message that definitely needs to be brought upon about children, but I'd say, like, it doesn't have as much to say as, like, another Disney animated film that came out earlier, like Zootopia. Like, Zootopia had a lot of themes and messages as opposed to Moana. It really only had, like, one message that had heart and didn't try to do too much. It was a nice contained story and didn't try to do too much, which I can appreciate because that just means that with this movie, it's definitely kind of like a throwback to old school Disney with their princesses or just their happily ever after type stories. But at the same time, it brings something new because one thing I noticed is that Moana, she doesn't rely on a man to help her save the day, which I love. I love when Disney, they make princesses or just female characters that don't need a man and that are just not the typical damsel in distress and that they can stand on their own. And the climax of this movie was just really exciting to me. I think the climax of this movie was what really brought the movie home for me. And I just think they couldn't have ended this movie even better than what was presented to us in the climax of the movie. And I just love it. But in the end, Moana, I love this movie. I think it was a throwback to classic Disney. And it's definitely will be a classic years from now. The music is great. The voice cast was perfect. It had heart. The animation was great. I'm going to give Moana 5 stars, for it's a masterpiece. Thank you so much for watching, and if you like this video, go ahead and hit that thumbs up button. If you want to see more, go ahead and check out my channel. The link is in the description below. And be sure to check me out on Facebook, Twitter, Tumblr, Instagram, MoviePilot, and Periscope. Peace.